I have been looking forward to this day for quite some time as a baseball fan. As many know, well, they probably don't know. I helped to run the longest running weekly Philly sports podcast show in the world. It's called the Philadelphia Sports Table Podcast Show. And as a result, I have the opportunity every now and then to meet and talk to a lot of really great people in the world of Philly sports. So my co-host Erik and I, we are going to be heading out to Reading, Pennsylvania to what's called the Reading Hot Stovers annual event. They give scholarships to high school baseball players, and it's a really cool event from what I understand. It's my first time going, and they have great guests. Dan Plesac is going to be there. Greg Luzinski is going to be there. And also Lou Trivino, who is a pitcher with the Oakland Athletics. I cannot wait to get out there. Why? Because Erik and I have press passes to interview these guys and talk to them. It's an amazing opportunity. I want to thank my buddy Josh Tremble because, well, not only is he my cousin-in-law, but he's provided us this opportunity. So thank you so much, Josh. All right, I'm gonna get going now. If there is one thing I truly despise, it's freaking traffic. I despise it. Oh my gosh. All right, I just got here to Josh's, and we are going to be heading to the Reading Doubletree Hotel for this event. I can't wait. As you can see, I put on my jacket. Yes. I have to look good for this thing. I normally don't. It's going to be awesome. We're on our way right now. It's going to be a fun time. This is going to be awesome. What? Why do I look so dopey in this jacket? Yes, I know I should have my seatbelt on. All right, well, we just got here. That's the man right there, Josh Tremble. There he is. He's the reason why I am here. What's up, buddy? How you doing? Doing a little vlogging. It's a little vlogging. What's up?
Nothing.
How you doing?
I didn't wear a suit.
How you doing?
I'm excited to hear the show afterwards.
I think we might have to actually do a podcast just based on this night. That's what I'm thinking, actually. That'd be awesome.
Sort of replace the old the interview ones you did.
Yeah, the table talk ones.
That's it.
Yeah. I think aside from my kids being born and my wedding, this is the greatest night of my life.
Is this
like one of the greatest nights of your life?
No.
No? Okay.
It's fine.
Well, yeah. It's a good time. Yeah. Man of very few words.
Yeah, it was small school, and I was fortunate enough to go and play Legion and do well. And then I made a Legion showcase, and I pitched in front of all these scouts. And then the same story. I had like a 6'9", and then they're like, "Lou, you know what? I don't think starting is for you. We're gonna throw you the bullpen." And I was livid, but you can't really argue because I was so bad. So you have to deal with what you had, and then. And it was one of those things where at that moment in 2015, like everything changed for me. You know, I knew that I wasn't throwing well at the time. I was 86 to 89, 90. I mean, before, you know, I would show glimpses of 95, 96 when I was in spring training, but I just never threw that hard. I always knew that I could throw harder. And I distinctly remember I was watching a guy named Ray Black. He's actually from Pittsburgh. Never talked to him, but he probably knows the story because this is kind of how I'm about. But I was watching him throw, and this guy threw absolute fuzz. I mean, he was 98 to 103. Just threw hard. And like just like anything in life, you want to watch the best at what you do play. Like whether it's golf, baseball, business, you want to watch who's ever better than you do whatever you're doing. So I was watching him, I was mentally comparing him versus me, and I realized he was doing something I wasn't. So I'm like, all right, I'm going to try that. So one outing, I went from 88, 90, maybe touched 91, and the very next outing, I remember I was talking to my dad. I was like, Dad, I think I'm hitting 95 today. He's like, you know what, Lou, don't tell me you're hitting 95, just show me you're hitting 95. I'm like, all right, I'll show you. I was 94, 95, overnight, 2 days later, just like that. And then my next outing, I said, Dad, I think I'm hitting 97. He said the same thing to me. And I was 95, 97. It was incredible. So I finished up pretty well. And then the next year, I came to spring training, and they told me I was going to be a long relief guy because I excelled in that. And my very first outing in spring training, I was 97, 99, and they immediately said, you're going to be a closer.
Career, I believe, four or five times, he finished in the top five in fielding percentage by left fielders. Just think about that for a second. I know you can say, yeah, you only played seven innings, and Maddox and Boa got everything else. I know you can say that. But he was in the top five quite a bit as a left fielder. Of course, he was a member of the 1980 world champion Philadelphia Phillies. Please welcome back to the Hot Stovers, the Bull, Greg Luzinski.
First of all, congratulations to all award winners. But looking at this program, this is my fifth time here. I don't remember any. You know, Redding's my favorite place, believe it or not. It's the greatest minor league town in the country. Trust me. I'll never forget, I got on that plane in Clearwater, Florida, flew to, obviously, Philadelphia International, got on the bus, and went to the stadium. From there, they took us to the Abraham Lincoln Hotel. Great place. After that, Jimmy Bronson, very young general manager. He was our general manager at the time. One of the first people he introduced me to, he said, these guys will really help you find a place to stay, because at that time it was really tough to find a place, and I was married at a young age, so I had a wife and kid. So who do I get introduced to but Ducky Turner and Bob Mazzley. Yeah. Third baseman ever played the game and things of that nature. And Schmitty took two-peat and became obviously one of the best third basemen in the game. And career-wise, I've been fortunate enough to play with five or six teams. And Sizemore missed that ball. And ended up, I think it was a pinch hitter, ended up going to third base.
Oh, man, we did not get a chance to see Dan Plesac. Greg Luzinski was going on and on and on, but it was fantastic. It really was. I think he had a little bit, but we got to head home. It is snowing out right now, so I'm going to catch you when I get home, okay? Yes, it is a couple days later here, and I just couldn't continue to do the vlogging at the end of the evening and at the end of the event. I was just completely spent. I was completely tired when I got home. But when I look back on this event and I kind of reflect on what it meant to me, listen, there's a lot of individuals out there in, quote, sports media who've had these opportunities. They've been in front of these icons and legends, people who have played the game of baseball for so many years and have meant a lot to different fan bases. I didn't take it for granted at all. I really didn't. Honestly, my buddy Josh, who you saw in the video, he was the reason why Erik and I were able to go out there. And I thank him. And I would cherish this night for the rest of my life. And again, it's coming from a place of being really humble about where I started on my sports media journey. And I am by no means, and even my co-host by no means, we're not experts in any broadcasting field or anything like that. We've been doing our Philadelphia Sports Table podcast show for almost 6 years. In April 2019, it'll actually be 6 years that we've been doing the show. Len and I started off first 5 years. Erik joined us last year. It's been a real cool endeavor We're not the biggest podcast out there. We're not the most famous podcast out there, but we've had the opportunity to talk to some really cool people over the years. It doesn't happen like every week or anything like that. We get great guests on our show, but it's not anything where we're talking to legends and icons every week. So I think that's why this Reading Hot Stovers event was so very special, I know for myself. So, and I know it was for Erik as well. I'm really gonna cherish it for the rest of my life. I don't know how this vlog is going to turn out. It's something a little different. It's focused just on myself here, the girls and Michelle not involved in this one at all. I didn't know what to expect at the event, so in terms of the footage, I wasn't too sure what I would be getting and what I could, what I couldn't get, and things like that. So we'll see how this turns out, but I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope it conveyed how special of an event it was and how special it was for me. So until the next one, take care, everybody. See you later.